The Center for Public Service Innovation was established in 2001 by Minister for Public Service and Administration to act as a facilitator for the unearthing, development and implementation of innovative ideas within and throughout the public service. In 2010, the CPSI launched the Multimedia Innovation Center to demonstrate, encourage, and inspire the creation of a dynamic new way of thinking within the public service sector. This center is also designed to act as a planning, testing, and piloting platform of innovative solutions to public service delivery challenges.
I think the thought behind coming up with an innovation center is to try and get to public servants to do things differently. And because innovation is quite evasive, so we needed to provide a physical space.
If you look at how the whole center has been designed, it's been designed in a manner that it allows for creativity. It allows people to come out of their normal comfort zones. It allows for people to go in an environment that's very comfortable, which is with the right media staff to help them think creatively, which is what we need quite a lot in government.
We decided on an interactive facility because it's only when people really participate in the processes that they learn. So I'm a strong believer, you know, of participatory learning.
We say nothing is impossible. Through innovation, there is no area where you then say we can't provide an answer as a solution to the challenge that confronts you. So it's very much important to have CPSI.
Acting as a central knowledge hub, the center is able to provide an ongoing, constantly current resource of knowledge for all government departments to access and build on. The center also aims to identify, support, and nurture innovation with a view to ultimately improving service delivery across the board.
Well, knowledge management is really the driver for innovation. Without giving people access to content, to knowledge, you are actually depriving them of the opportunity to kickstart their own creative thinking. So the content is of extreme importance because it's the case, very practical case studies, and we push the issue of learning from one another so that one province doesn't come up with an innovation and it gets sold by consultants to another province at double the price.
The response from public sector institutions has been overwhelming. They have found a very good platform for them to find solutions. We had visits from the Department of Correctional Services, Department of Water Affairs, the Limpopo Premier's Office, and all of them, when we show them one of their services in a visual manner, they actually were able to realize where they may have made mistakes, where they need to improve their processes. And in that sense, it has actually been very overwhelming in it, that it gives people the opportunity to visualize the delivery of their services.
So when you come through the Innovation Center, we would like to see people being transformed or just reaffirmed that they are actually creative and innovative beings, and that they can apply those creative skills within the public sector. And the equipment, the content, is all geared towards getting people in that particular mode, within that approach of being creative and finding solutions for the challenges that we are facing on a day-to-day level.
The Multimedia Innovation Center is divided into six different areas and overall has a dual purpose. The Knowledge Platform section focuses on information and knowledge sharing. It also demonstrates successful practices by showcasing inspirational case studies, both from here in South Africa as well as abroad. Then there's the planning platform, which is used as a tool for departments to interrogate their own processes, engage in process mapping, and plot out innovative solutions for their respective sectors.
CPSI is located in an environment where it links to every government department by attracting government departments to bring their ideas here, share those ideas, and then disseminate them back. So they are sort of in a position where they are a market for ideas in terms of what's happening in government. So you'd find that a process that needs to be fixed in the Department of Home Affairs would be a similar process that needs to be fixed in the Department of Water Affairs. It could be supply chain management. And they are better positioned to be able to bring that connection and do that.
The center provides space for public servants and partners to step out of their sometimes stifling environments, to interrogate their challenges with other stakeholders and experts, and explore innovative solutions. Guests are welcomed by an audio-visual introduction on a wall projection, which focuses on how to become innovative in the public sector, introducing users to the concepts of effective leadership, organizational culture, teamwork and partnerships, as well as the organization of knowledge exchange. Each area of the center is designed to allow participants to interact with different media. The floor projection encourages visitors to actively participate, and this relaxed, game-like functionality is perfect for putting people at ease and helping them enter into the right mindset for creative, solutions-based thinking and innovation. The first iPointer system is a learning tool for innovation. It focuses on factors that foster innovation in the public sector, such as diversity of staff and exploiting differences, to developing metrics for success. The second iPointer system is a demonstration system showcasing innovative projects undertaken in South Africa as well as globally. The touchscreen table has planning tools on processes, approaches, and methodologies to improve service delivery. Processes can be mapped, reconfigured, and finalized for piloting or implementation. The touch wall can be used by up to three people simultaneously. The current processes installed in the multi-touch wall are Department of Home Affairs ID application process and Department of Health hospital visitation processes. By being able to visually engage with processes and planning in this way, the participants get a larger overview and they can then work together to come up with better ways of doing things.
If you look at the innovation terrain, innovation thrives on partnerships. If you don't have strategic value-adding partnerships, then innovation won't fly. And I think this is the message that I want to send to public servants, to say the case studies that they have out there are very important to make sure that the innovation center is always, you know, on the cutting edge of matters and issues.
This is not a facility for the CPSI to enjoy, but a platform for the entire public sector to build on and exploit its benefits. We invite our colleagues across government to embrace this facility and make it their own.
We see CPSI as the platform for the public sector to use us to integrate their services, to be able to deliver services in an integrated manner for the citizens of South Africa so that we improve the lives of our citizens and for economic and social development of our country.
In the next 5 years, the CPSI will be in a bigger space, and the CPSI will be buzzing with public servants coming in. They will have taken ownership of the facility, and it will be buzzing with public servants coming in to contribute their own content and to just sit in the CPSI and become creative thinkers.
I would like to see the CPSI as an innovator of choice for all our public service, all departments, all government institutions. An innovator of choice. When anyone thinks of innovation, that person must think CPSI. That's where I would like to see them.
For more information, or if you can contribute to the knowledge repository, contact us at info@cpsi.co.za or call us at 012-683-2800.